This video in the description. We're gonna start out with these two layers, the photo frame background and the snowboarder. I have them on two different layers, of course. And what we wanna do is we wanna isolate this black area here. You can, of course, create a selection around the black area to isolate it, but I like working with vectors better because they give you smaller file sizes and they're easier to edit. So we're gonna create a vector around the frame. So I'm gonna press V on the keyboard, I'm holding the V key, I'm not letting go of it, and I'm going to zoom in to the corner here, and release the V key, it'll bring me back to the pen tool which I had selected. Make sure that you have shape on the options panel, on the drop down. Click on one corner, you click on the next, hold the space bar, pan down, click on the bottom right corner, and then click on the bottom left corner. I'm going to hold the space bar again. Click and drag to pan up and complete that path. Now the color of the shape really doesn't matter, so I'm just going to make it red just so that you can see it. There it is, red. What I'm going to do now is enable the layer for the snowboarder. I'm going to click and drag her up to the top of the layers panel. And I'm also going to double tap here on the zoom tool just so we can see the image at 100%. And actually, now that I'm looking at it at 100%, I'm actually going to right click on it and choose fit on screen so that I can see the entire composition. Then I'm going to press Ctrl J, Command J on the Mac to duplicate. So now I have two copies. I'm going to disable the one on the top by clicking on this eye icon, and the one on the bottom here, I'm going to clip to the shape below it. So with that layer selected, I'm going to press Ctrl Alt G, Command Option G on the Mac. Then I'm going to enable the layer right above that. And I'm just going to make a selection around the snowboarder. So I'm going to click on the quick selection tool. And I'm simply going to click and drag around her. Now you don't have to be very precise at this moment. You can just click and drag. And we'll worry about the details later. So we're just going to select her as quick as we can. So I'm just clicking and dragging. And notice that my selection is not very accurate. You shouldn't spend too much time at this moment. If you select an area like this part here that you need to transform to scale this and adjust it accordingly. If you can't see the corner handles that you want to click and drag on, you can press Control 0, that's Command 0 on the Mac, for the bird's eye view that allows you to see all four corner handles. Then I'm going to click and drag this one here to scale it down by holding Shift Alt, that's Shift Option on the Mac. Now at this point, we can go back and adjust the layer mask if we need to. So I'm going to zoom in just so we can see the areas that we can work on. We need to work on this area and then the blue outline around her body. So we can adjust that by clicking on the layer mask in the properties panel. You can click on mask edge. If you don't see the properties panel, you can go to window, properties. Click on mask edge and then maybe shift the edge with a negative value and see how that adjusts. So you keep adjusting it and making sure that that line is gone, but we don't lose any detail that we want to keep. Also, with this brush selected, I can click and drag here on the hair, and hopefully we'll get a better selection. Now, it didn't do that good of a job here, so I'm just going to leave it like this for now, and then I can come back with the brush tool and fix that in a moment. So I'm going to press OK, click on the brush tool, paint with white in areas that I want to keep. So I'm just going to paint with white in these areas here. And I know I'm still liking some of the sky, but that's OK. I'm going to get rid of that by pressing X on the keyboard, which swaps the foreground and background color. And with black, I'm going to paint on that layer mask to get rid of the sky here. And I'm not going to take the time to do so now. I will do that after the tutorial and you can see the final image, but I'm just going to go around the entire image and just make sure that everything is masked out accordingly. And in most of these areas, everything seems to be okay. I know we gotta work on this area here. And like I said, I'll do that after I'm done with the tutorial and you can see my final result. But for now, we'll just leave it as is. I'm gonna press V on the keyboard, right click, and choose the screen. And what we're gonna work on now is extra elements that are gonna help our composite look much more realistic and much more interesting. So from the Adobe Stock Library, I downloaded two elements we're gonna use. We're gonna use this shovel with the snow, so let me just double click on that to open that up. And by the way, there'll be watermark TV to practice on, so I would recommend you doing that just so that you can have a way to practice and learn. So the first thing I gotta do is get rid of this shovel. I'm gonna click on the lasso tool, I'm gonna make a selection around this shovel, and as you can see, it's not very accurate. It's okay. Then I can hold shift and backspace, or you can go into edit, fill to bring up the fill menu under contents. Choose Content Aware and press OK. And Photoshop will fill in those pixels and make the shovel disappear. I'm going to press Control D, Command D on the Mac to deselect. And this is what we're going to work with. The first thing that we need to do is mask out the snow from the ground. So I'm going to go into the Channels panel, and I'm going to look for the channel that's got the most contrast. In this case, the blue channel. I'm going to click and drag on the blue channel and drop it here in the new channel icon, duplicate it. Now with the duplicate channel, I can start making adjustments to it. The first thing I'm going to do is fill with white on the areas that I want to keep for sure. So with the lasso tool selected, I'm just going to click and drag and make a very rough selection on the areas that I know for sure I want to keep, which is all this top part here. Now that I have the selection active, I can represent it more. And once again, I'm going to go to Image, Adjustment, Levels, darken up some of the darker pixels and brighten up the midtones a little bit, and press OK. So this selection looks like it'll work. So I'm going to press Control, Command on the Mac, click on the blue copy icon to make a selection around it, go back into the Layers panel, on the background layer, which is the only layer that we have in this document, I'm going to click on the new layer mask icon, and notice now that the floor is no longer there. Now, it's not a perfect selection, but it's going to work because the color of the floor and the color of the table are very similar colors, and I think we're going to be able to get away with it. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to simply click on the layer, select the Move tool, click and drag the layer over onto the other file by hovering over the tab, then coming down and releasing, and there's our file. It's a really big layer, so we're going to need to scale it down. Control-T, Command-T in the back, Transform. We can't see the corner handles, so I'm going to press Control-0, Command-0 on the Mac. There's the corner handles, and now I'm going to adjust them accordingly. I'm holding Shift as I'm clicking on these corner handles to keep the file constrained. The angle is not really matching my theme, so I'm going to right-click on it and choose Flip Horizontal. And from here, I can match the scene a little bit better, and I can even distort it if I want to. Maybe right-click on it and choose Distort just to get a better perspective of the scene that we're working with, maybe something like this. And press Enter when you're done. Now that we have this file in place, I'm going to press V on the keyboard, right-click, Fit to Screen. Then I'm going to press V on the keyboard to get the Move tool, and maybe I can move it around if I need to. And I'm going to click on the new group icon to create a new group. I'm going to click and drag this snow layer in there. I'm going to collapse it, and now it's in that group. Next, I'm going to hold Alt, Option on the Mac, and click on the layer mask icon to create a black layer mask which hides everything. Then, with the brush tool, I can paint with white on this layer mask to start revealing some of that snow. So I'm going to use the bracket keys on the keyboard as I work to increase and decrease the size of my brush. So I'm just painting with white, just bringing in some of that snow. And if you make a mistake, you can press X on the keyboard, black, and maybe shape the snow a little bit better. Maybe something like that. What we're gonna do now is work with different elements. So I'm gonna open up the libraries panel, and I'm gonna open up this file here, which is the snow elements that were also downloaded from Adobe Stock. By the way, if you don't have Photoshop CC, you won't have the libraries panel, but you can still download the watermark previews onto your desktop and bring them into Photoshop as you would any other image. So you can still work with the previews. So what I'm going to do now is just select one of these elements and bring it over to the file that I'm working with. So I'm going to click on the lasso tool and I'm going to select this element first. So I'm going to select it, go to edit and copy, or you can